Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Skill Forum. So in this session I am going to explain the procedure of design of helical gear. So in the last session I have explained the basics of an helical gear as well as the nomenclatures of an helical gear and what are all the equations we have to define the nomenclatures or notations of an helical gear, as well as we have done with the forces of an helical gear. If you have not watched that video, click this I button, you will get the video of that particular session. Okay, so still if you have not subscribed to my channel, do subscribe my channel and click the bell icon so that you will get the notifications of my new video updates. Okay, so let's start. So as I told you, in the design of spur gear problems, first you need to define the given data. So first step is, so this is very important, you should have to concentrate, we need to write the given data. So by using this only you can easily identify what are all the parameters you need to solve, right? So first you need to write the given data. Next step is the same. See, the design procedure of an helical gear is same as spur gear. So only some differences you will get and some equations will be changed in this design of helical gear problems. Okay, so next is we need to identify the weaker member. So this is the second step. So as I told you in the first session of an helical gear, so here to define an helical gear you need to use Lewis form factor equation. So as the Lewis factor, it depends on a virtual number of teeth of an helical gear. So here you need to use the same equation, and first you need to find out number of teeth Z1 and Z2, then you need to use the Lewis form factor equation. So the equation will be displayed on your screen. You just refer same equation whatever you have used in the design of spur gear problems. Only thing is, instead of Z you need to use ZV, right? So to find out ZV, we have an equation. So you will get the equation. So ZV, that is virtual number of teeth, we have an equation Z by cos cube beta. So you need to use this equation. So this Z will be number of teeth, Z1 and Z2, that data will be given in the question itself. If in some questions if he has not given the number of teeth, you have to assume the number of teeth in pinion as 20, so that you can solve Z2 also by using velocity factor equation, right? So velocity ratio equation. So this is how you can solve. Next, what you need to do, you need to identify weaker member by using sigma naught into y. So one would be for pinion and sigma naught to y1 you need to find out. So whichever is smaller you need to consider that is a weaker member. Okay, so this sigma naught is allowable stress, that will be given in the question. If he has not given in the question, you have to refer the particular table. You just you will get the table on your screen, so that you will refer that. So that is table 23.48. table 23.48, you just use this table and just assume the material with respect to your requirement. So put that value, you will get the weaker member. Okay, so once you identify the weaker member, for that weaker member you need to design an helical gear, right? So next is, third step is design. So to design an helical gear, first step is we need to identify the tangential tooth load. So first is tangential tooth load with respect to power. So we have an equation that is that will be displayed on your screen. So in that equation you have n into r, right? N you need to consider the speed of the particular weaker member, and r, so in the spur gear r will be d/2, right? So but in case of a helical gear you need to consider this r. So you need to consider this R. So you need to consider this R is equal to d by 2, right? So we have this d equation, right? That is, d is nothing but mnz by cos beta. So use this equation, you will get mnz by 2 cos beta. So z you need to use z1, don't forget about this number of teeth. No need to use zv. Only thing is you need to use whatever you have, whatever he has given in the question, that number of teeth you need to consider. So next you need to substitute this value with the tangential tooth load equation with respect to power, and you will get the tangential tooth load equation. Okay, so next is we have to find out tangential tooth load for Lewis equation. So we need to find out this for Lewis equation. So you have an equation, you just refer that equation 23.288. Equation 23, I will just write that equation. Ft is equal to, we have sigma naught By, sigma naught By, and Pt Kv cos beta divided by Cw. Cw. So here you will get an equation 23.286. So here you have a transverse pitch, right? Pt you have an equation. So P, and so all the equations you will get in your data handbook itself. So where you will get, I have explained in the previous video, you just refer that video. We have Pn by cos beta. You just simplify it, so you will get all the values. So here Kv, velocity factor, you need to find out whatever I have explained in the design of spur gear problem. So only thing is, so you need to consider this Cw. That is, Cw is nothing but wear and lubrication factor. So this is wear and lubrication factor. So Cw, to determine the Cw, you just refer the table 23.13. Sorry, not 23.13. You just refer 23.47. Table 23.47. You will just get the table on your screen. You just refer that equation. So to determine this Cw, that is wear and lubrication factor, you need to assume scant lubrication with scant lubrication but frequent inspection. So that you need to assume it. With respect to that, you will get an value of Cw. So once you substitute all the values, so same way whatever you have determined in the design of spur gear, you will get an equation with respect to m cube kv with some value. Okay, so with respect to this, you need to determine next. Fine, so got it. So next, what you need to do, so once you get the equation, so once you get the equation, so you need to do some trials by assuming standard. So this mn, assume standard value mn from 3 or 4, 5 or 6. So you just assume it by considering the module value 3 or 4 or from 5 or from 6. Okay. So if this mn cube kv value is less than 20, you just you start considering module value from 3. If it is more than 25-30, you just consider it from 5 and 6. Okay, so same way you need to assume it. So once you get a module value, so what you need to do is, so you need to check for stresses. So once you get module value, you can get remaining values also. Okay, so what you have to find out, so here Next, we need to check for stresses. How to check for stresses? So we need to check for stresses. So if the allowable stress, you need to find out allowable stress as well as induced stress. So to find out the allowable stress, this is KV. That is allowable. So you need to find out this allowable stress. You just substitute these values with respect to weaker member. So you'll get allowable stress. Next, you need to find out the induced stress. Induced stress, that is, we have an equation that is for induced stress. We have Ft Cw. So to find out the induced stress in an helical gear, you have to use this equation, that is ByKv. So you just refer this equation so that you will get, so B is nothing but 10m, B is equal to 10m, and Y is 10mn, Y is equal to pi mn. Okay, so you just substituted it, you will get an allowable stress value. Okay, so if the induced stress is less than allowable stress, then the design is safe, right? So we need to define that. Next is very important. To avoid the breakage in the teeth, we need to determine the effective force. With respect to effective force only, we can define the force, what force we have to produce in that particular helical gear. So to define an effective force, we have EFF, that is effective force. We have an equation Ft Cs. Cs is nothing but safety factor. Then we have Kv, right? So Cs already we have defined in the tangential tooth load equation. So that is service factor, not safety factor. Service factor, you just find out. So Ft already you will get when you solve Mn value, right? So once you find out, you need to find out the beam force also, beam strength. So for that, we have an equation sigma naught By, sigma naught By Pn divided by Cw. So this is the bending of strength equation. So if the bending strength equation is greater than effective force, if the bending strength equation is greater than effective force, then we can say the design is safe. So with respect to these two values, we can find out factor of safety. What is the factor of safety we have? That is effective force by bending force, right? So this is how you need to find out the you need to check for stresses, right? So once you find out the stresses, next you need to determine, next you need to find out the basic dimension parameters of helical gear. So you need to find out this. So to find out this basic dimension, you just refer table 23.1. So you will get on your display, and then you need to find out center distance also. Then you need to refer equation 23.247. So these equations you need to consider to determine the basic parameters of an helical gear. Once you find out these, next is very important. That is dynamic load. So we need to find out the dynamic load. So why we need to find out? To identify the dynamic strength of a helical gear. So we have an equation that is, you just refer 23.309A, equation 23.309 yeah, you will get on your screen. You just refer that equation so that you can solve the problem. You can solve the equation. So in this equation, you need to find out the error with respect to class of gear. So with respect to error, you need to find out. You have to refer and you have to find out the dynamic load factor also. So the dynamic load factor you need to find out by using 23.35. So use this equation so that you will get dynamic load factor, and also after this you need to find out the interpolation. After this you need to use interpolation method to solve the basic dimension of the basic values of this dynamic load, right? So once you find out the dynamic load, you have to find out endurance strength. So endurance strength, so we have an equation 23.293. So you just refer this equation 23.293, so you can find out the endurance strength value. So next, at last, so in this endurance strength value, so you will get an equation. You just refer this equation 23.293, right? So 23.293, so you will get all the values so that you can easily find out the endurance strength. So one more thing, next you need to find out the wear strength also. To find out that wear strength, we need to use Buckingham's equation. Wear strength, wear load. So to find out the wear load, you just refer equation 23.310, so that you will get the particular equation. We need to use according to Buckingham's equation. Okay, so we have an equation that is Fw is equal to d1bqk divided by cos square beta. So you just refer this equation, you will get, you have d1b and q, so q is nothing but ratio factor. Q you will get in equation 23.163. You just refer whatever you have referred in the design of spur gear. And when it comes to K, so that K you need to find out by using equation 23.311, that is factorial stress square by sin alpha n, then 0.7 E n, right? So you need to use this equation, that is 23.311. You just refer this equation, you can solve all the parameters. See, this is not En, this is E naught. So that is equivalent modulus. E naught you will get by equation 23.162. And then structural stress you need to find out. Structural stress, you have an equation called 2.75 Hb minus 69, that is in terms of MPa. You have to refer an equation 23.294, you will get on your screen. You just refer this equation 23.294a. by using this equation, you will get factorial stress. When you will get factorial stress? If in the question he has given Hb is nothing but Brennel hardness number, if he has given the particular weaker member hardness number, you just substitute it, you will get factorial. Or else what you need to do, you just find out by substituting all the values here, you will get K value and this value also. With respect to K and factorial stress, you have to find out the, so if in the question he has asked find out the hardness, Brennel hardness number, you just find out with respect to K and refer table number So you just refer a table whatever I have displayed on your screen, so that you will get the hardness number also. Okay, so that's all about the basic procedure of an helical gear to solve the problem. Okay, so if you like this video, do share this video with your friends, so that your friends will get helpful with this video. So stay tuned for my next videos.